They've got to find something.
Tregenza's in there. Perhaps he can find it. Taken there by Dillon. Met heavily. Perhaps it was too high. Yes, it was. Turbill tackled. Definitely too high. You saw it right down the lens of the camera. Taken across there by Turbill towards a half forward flank. It's all Norwood and this is the last quarter.
Getting him forward. McFarlane has the ball. Johnny Wynn, and that's the sort of determination he showed all day as he gets it out to little Turbill. Turbill heads down into attack. He's only a youngster, but he's going to be a real good. And there's Gallagher, had a brilliant first half. Yes, here it goes again. And you would be lucky if you'd got 20-1 at the start of the season then.
You would be too.
Two goals.
Dillon, we suspect, is not too fit. Over towards Gallagher. Gallagher with a short kick over towards Turbill. Point right into Turbill. It'll be a Turbill mark.
Oh, now well done, Gallagher. That handball was waited for. Polder stood his ground. He knew that there was going to be no kick. And Dillon coolly handballed back. And then it was set up for you to see Voigt give the free kick away to number 17, Turbill. Dead set in front.
Has
the
kicked,
mark and free kick was there.
Has kicked 38 goals this season. 39th for the year if he gets it.
There it is.
What an important goal for the Red League.
Turbill, who kicked 6 goals last week. And we named him best on ground. He won the Seiko Award. He's a very talented footballer.
You've got to remember, Norwood couldn't get a goal from this position last week and they went over Port. There's the tap down. Button winning the taps well. Gets it down towards Copping. Knocked away from him by Turbill. Geez, a clever ball handler. Gets it out.
Couldn't thump it down. Taken there by Gregor. Beautiful hand pass over to Turbill. Turbill's kick down to Dillon. Beauty.
Immediately you can feel the electric sparks from all the players around him and from the spectators who always expect action when Wynn's near the ball. To the half forward line and Turbill, and Norwood is starting a bit better than against the breeze than I expected. They go into the forward pocket and
Wynn was doing the hard work. He was just picking himself up. Max, he's doing a good job.
His butt from the back gets it down a little. Turbill, my word, he's a good rover. Over to Seacamp.
Comes up nicely for Austin. He handled it well too. Kicks into Johnny Wynn and it's Norwood keeping the pressure on all the time as it's little Turbill. Turbill's kick down ground. Nice. Craig, and it's Norwood doing everything right. And here's a player that's really played well. Greg, untidy, unselfish, a great club man. Down to Turbill. Turbill onto Craig, and these two have combined cleverly. A brilliant player, but Button's kick on four. That's the first top kick of the match, and where's it go? Little Turbill, one of the best rovers in the state. Onto Craig, onto Dillon. Dillon looking sharper now. Onto Turbill. Turbill should have been met. He wasn't. He'll get a free kick, surely.
Here's
Woodcock. He dropped the ball.
Steadying, seeks the help of Adler, a bad bounce. Tapped into the path of Turbill. Turbill goes to ground. Through goes Walk. Still there. Heinrich now. A fine tackle. But he's been paid for legging. The free kick will go to Philip Heinrich. Back pocket player for Sturt. As umpire Mead talks to Greg Turbill.
Sturt.
Turbill leads it back to Taylor. Norwood looking to set up something constructive. Short passes on, and Adamson marks at half forward. He looks for the lead of Adler, but it's a shocking kick. Adler possession, back to Finneman. Now Turbill in turn. Adamson, he's running into an open goal. He converts without any problems whatsoever.
Drama. The half forward line, and Turbill gets a bad bounce. Up Hargrave, chance for Norwood, through Turbill to Adamson, he's got three, heads for the open goal, and I think he's got number four.
Craig's got a direct run at goal, puts it out to Noonan, walks there, up comes Adler, looking for help, can't get it, he's got around, can't get through however, hits it over to Turbill, and Turbill runs into an open goal. Goal number one goes on the board to the Norwood Rover, and goal number 13 for the Red Reds. No one need be present, he's got a heart problem. Gallagher tapped it down to Von Berto. Bagshaw steals it but couldn't get through. He put his elbow up and has been... Yes, the free kick's gone against him for putting up the elbow. And Greg Turbill showing, or is it... It is Greg Turbill showing.
Casey to the outer side once more. Bagshaw will be the leaper. One hand to it, but it goes straight through the pack to Turbill. He's been paid the mark. Blood streaming down his jaw. Norwood, 9 points down. Have reduced their deficit from 29 at the throw-in. Went up high, grabs the ball, looking to pass off. Sanders in there, players can hardly scratch themselves at the moment. Turbill heads in towards the open goal again. I think he's got the second. Goal! Norwood and down now back to within 3 points. Off Sturt with Turbill's second goal. Nicholson
wide to the outer side. Seconds running out. Howard in pursuit. Turbill over there as well. Goes for the safety of the line. Time on Norwood side now. Seconds running out. Siren imminent. Would have a great deal of time left. Too far out to score. Sends out the pass to Downs. Winder can't make it. Bergen in there as well. There's the siren. Norwood have won. Norwood have won. One of the most sensational grand finals in the history of the game. Underdogs. They have gone up from a deficit of 29 points to beat Sturt by 1 point. Jerry, what a magnificent final. General manager, football director, Wally Miller, Michael Taylor. Jerry, unbelievable scene.
Well, it certainly is, Ian. They don't come any better than this. Absolute emotional scenes ringing out here.
Come and have a look at this, David Palm.
Hey, what are you?
I mean, what
have you done there? I tried to kiss back.
Well done, young fella. Those two goals in the last one.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was the national anthem. Now, Greg, tell us about those goals in the last quarter.
Oh, shit, I don't...
Well, give us a drink.
Give a drink there, Daisy.
Okay. I don't know, it's just part of the winning combination. Three-quarter time, I believe we could do it. But I'll tell you what, there were 9 other blokes out there that, geez, they put in a magnificent
Greg, it's fantastic. When you lost the lead in the last quarter, what did you think?
I started praying on the first time I've ever done it.
Yeah. How did you get that? That looks awful.
Oh, I ran into a fast-moving bag, sure.
Don't worry about it. In half an hour, you'll forget all about it.
Make the distance, however, but it's a chance for Nolan. Oh, what a mark. Turbill it is, coming across, fading in from the pocket, took a great mark.
Got under the fall of the ball tended to float around in the air. He had both the ability and the presence of mind to put his hand under the fall of that ball and has taken a critical mark just 25 metres out dead in front. And what's he done? Made absolutely no mistake.
Keen steadying. Oh, he's in trouble. That's mucking around in defence. That gets you into trouble all the time. As Turbill gets the resulting free kick and the resulting goal. Over to Linky, who doesn't handle it well either. Over to Hawkins. Back it goes to Naley. Good pressure play, though, by the defensive forward as they work it away. Turbill out towards the centre wing. That's a beautiful...
For a reason that I couldn't see, was awarded a free kick. His kick was back to the centre, but there's the big long arms of Nick Walker to take a good mark.
Promising young player, Nick Walker.
The kick is good to Turbill. David Collins head. Turbill lines up from 45 metres. He's done it again.
It's Michael Taylor, another hand pass, and that's a classical hand pass of Michael Taylor. Sorotsky's kick goes right in towards the square. Carl sets himself. Turbill! Oh, nearly a gazelle-like leap. What a beauty, right to the square. Dead in front.
Kick number 19 coming up from Greg Turbill. If you put that down along with 3 goals, 6 marks, 4 handballs, it just sums up what a valuable game it's been for his side. Probably only second to the captain. Dorotsky centres the ball. Turbill, the shortest of the group of players you'll see, as Ian Aitken called the gazelle, leaping from behind. Perfect pair of hands. Gets up, brings it down, and he made no mistake from 30 metres out.
That's Dunstan, who's also played well. Down towards Turbill. Second best player on the ground, according to Bob Hammond, and I wouldn't disagree.
Only surpassed by the magnificent captain of Norwood, Michael Taylor. Taylor's been superb. Greg Turbill has played an excellent game for his side. 4 goals, some 19-odd kicks, 4 handballs and 5 marks. Those statistics tell their own story.
Taylor has had 22 kicks, 7 marks and 15 handballs. Has shepherded, has guided, has done everything that a captain can do, and that's Turbill.
Tipping in, but Dunstan with the kick in towards goal. Looks good off the foot, but it hasn't quite made the distance. But I think a mark will be paid to the Norwood side. Greg Turbill. Mark there by Greg Turbill. Under extreme pressure, but showed his courage. And he should, in fact, put Norwood's first goal on the board. Greg Turbill, right in front, makes no mistake, straight through the middle. Norwood coming out through Sorotsky, back towards centre half forward. Dowd overrunning the ball. O'Brien, Turbill one on one. O'Brien pulled off the ball. Turbill does it well in towards goal. He's kicked his second. Magnificent foot from the forward side of centre towards centre half forward. Woodcock up home. Oh, great mark there by Van Dommel.
Kicking with the aid of probably a two or three goal breeze in this first quarter. Davies over the top looking for Heinrich. Grabs hold of Hoffman, holding the man. There's a bit of a go. Sanders, Turbill, Davies. Winnie's in there. And excitement running very high in the opening few.
There. So is John Witt. A long hand pass over to Turbill. Turbill going through, having a look at the goals. The kick's on its way. Good shepherding.
Winnie gathered possession. Knew that he had Turbill on the run, gave him a handball. Turbill looked up, had a look for the short pass, decided it wasn't on, then went long around the side of the body, 45 metres out.
Beats all players. Sanders, Turbill for 30 metres. Sure it goes.
Tremendous duel between Taylor and Craig. The ball eluded both, but it's Adler and Turbill disputing the possession. And it's Turbill finding the possession, and he made no mistake from 30 metres out.
Long, towards centre wing, the galloping Turnbull inside the square. Oh, he looked a hand pass, thought he might have been off. Steve Key thought he was too. In brilliant sunshine, nowhere to go. Changed his mind two or three times. No movement at all, and goes at last with a hand pass. To Rover Menzel, took the eye off the ball. Cox gives him a big serve. He's a very sore rover at the moment. Turnbull across the half forward line trying to drag the player. Doesn't do so. John Wynn says, go long. He does it. He spots Paul Adler on a long lead. And Norwood looking the goods at the moment. In comes Greg Turnbull again. Unattended, plenty of time, and then blows the whole lot by putting it straight across the goal face out of bounds.
Well,
tucked away into the forward pocket. Gets on with it before the hordes arrive into the square. Battles on. Oh, Greg Turnbull running the wrong way. He's put the body under the fall of the ball, and that's a magnificent mark to the little fella. I thought he's gone for all money after a very bitter and hard first half. Looked as if his legs had gone, but that was committing himself totally to the fall of the ball. You don't expect that from a little bloke running into a pack like that. That takes tons of courage.
Watch Turnbull come in against the tide. Great intestinal fortitude shown by the little fella then.
And the Rednecks put their game together very well. Another hand pass over. Albie Menzel. He's the hero at the moment. Little Greg Turnbull in the forward pocket. Back to co-rover Menzel. Fiddled around with it. Over to Gallagher. And Baines. Nowsley intercepting Jenkins. Over to little Greg Turnbull. Ducks and weaves. Comes onto the goal face. Kicks high.
But that's probably the best passage of football you'd want to see from an individual, particularly fighting back after great knee operations, propping around, opening up the...
...to put the legs into attack, up towards full forward, Adler in front, Cousins in, gets a bad bounce, quickly in now, Turbill running the ground from behind, and the Norwood Rover will get a set shot at goal from 35 metres out, almost in front, and a great start for Norwood.
Yeah, good start, Ian, and Colasanti got the first tap. He's a big man with a big body, and he's been very, very good for Norwood in the past couple of months.
Norwood has won the toss, kicking with just an ever-so-slight breeze. Turbill towards the golf course end, and he's put it through. The first goal of the game.
Norwood, 9-12, 66. Lead West Torrens, 8-7, 55 by 11 points, 16 minutes into the third term. As Turbill on the half-forward line. Dummies past the West Torrens player towards centre half forward. Cousins also up high there. The crumbs. Here's a chance for Norwood. The Jenkins again. Tipped it in short. Straight through the middle.
Dowd tries to tap it clear. He does on the second occasion. Searching for it. Turbill chips out a short pass. Woodcock again.
Menzel go to the half forward line. Looking for Woodcock over that player's head. But Turbill chips out towards Jenkins by himself. Goes in towards goal. And I think he's popped it. On the half-forward line.
Ken Torrens, no supporting players at all. They have to do it by individual efforts.
Good comment, Ian.
Menzel, the half forward line, a loose ball out towards Turbill. Here's a chance for the Norwood side. Nonchalantly popped through his second goal.
Handball over the top, almost went holding the ball just before that, but got it to his co-rover, incorrect Turbill, and he kicked the goal. That was his 17th, his 18th kick.
But it's all Norwood here through Michael Ace. Watch him do it cleverly. Isn't he a talented player? On the left boot, short, and in fact finds Turbill. He's met heavily by Shane Grambo. That's undisciplined football. Turbill's laid to rest. A 15-metre penalty kick. Here's in replay.
Turbill's a pretty tough player. He wouldn't put it on unless...
The Flash, as he's affectionately known, been a terrific footballer. Down towards the centre position, Turbill was hurt then in that heavy clash with the ground. One of the most courageous little players. Have a look at that in replay action again. Down goes Turbill.
Wouldn't do his cracked ribs any good.
No, I was going to say, Ian.
Stemper taking it, tackled, over to Turbill. Turbill under some suspect with that cracked ribs, but Michael Taylor, his captain, has taken the mark.
Hill to the outer side, the lead of Friedrichs. Walker, well done. Dowood slips over the handball. Turbill, 30 metres out, the angle's acute, and he puts it in the air. And it's a goal. At the throw-in, Dowood gets the tap down, looking for Turbill. Thomas is in there as well, and a high tackle has been ruled. It'll go the way of the Norwood Rover. Greg Turbill, 35 metres out on a 45-degree angle.
The Norwood Rover's doing particularly well. Turbill, tons and tons of courage, had plenty of touches, and so has Menzel. And most importantly, they're goal-kicking Rovers. Kick number 12 coming up for Turbill. He's already kicked a pretty good goal at the northern end. This one, a very important goal for Norwood.
The eyes of the Norwood camp squarely on number 17 as he splits the centre with a beautiful kick. Walker against Davies. In fact, it's two-on-one in there. Wynn was in as well, but Turbill comes out with the ball. Distributes it to Ace at centre wing. Heinrich now close on his hammer. The youngster clear, pushes it to the half forward line. Back now to Turbill. The pass going to Menzel, good pass by Turbill. And the Norwood Rover having a brilliant third quarter.
Dalwood, tap out, Turbill. Cleverly around, beautifully dummied. Short pass, Gallagher. But Adler at this stage of the final quarter, with two goals to his credit, would need to sink this through because Norwood trailed by 11 points, 13-14 Sturt. Norwood 12 goals, 9, an important kick for Paul Adler. Will this be his third goal? No, it's away to the right. Players gather under it. Turbill. Oh, what magic football with Turbill positioning himself beautifully down there. Opposition Casey. Turbill's booted two. Going to be a very sharp angle for the courageous Rover. Turbill having a good think about this. He's already thought about the movement that's coming around from Woodcock and company, but he doesn't want that. He wants his third goal. Can he thread it through? And Turbill has done that. Great mark, great kick. And that...
Possessions are very hard in grand finals. He'll regret that one.
Brad Moore wobbles one to midfield. Turbill, a legal shepherd. No, he's been paid the mark. Plays onto the half forward line, looking for Wynn. And the Norwood strongman... floating in towards full forward, Evans, Stasenowski, two on one, Stasenowski, Evans, nowhere to go, Turbill the tackler, coming through, but a free kick. All the players getting a little bit tense.
That's Turbill, he's nuts. You've got to be nuts to do that, you know, that height versus Evans.
Turbill free kick, short to Stepper at centre half back.
A short kick over to Turbill. Turbill has taken the mark. Turbill should kick a goal from there.
Norwood Rovers, Ian Aiken, are very dangerous. Kicked seven goals last week, four to Menzel and three to Turbill. Menzel, as we've seen, has already got one. Turbill is certainly within kicking distance. A courageous Rover. His career has been interrupted by leg injuries, but he's a magnificent footballer.
In actual fact, he's playing his 74th game this afternoon, and he's 24 years of age. So as Peter Mark has told you, he's missed a lot, but he hasn't missed a goal. That was his fourth kick, his first goal. Taken by Frank Stemper, left arm heavily strapped, out towards centre wing, looking for Taylor. The captain of Norwood has played very good football. Over to Turbill. Turbill tackle. Turbill to his feet, and once again...
Down the corner, all Port Adelaide back there. Bradmore can't take it, made a mistake. Oh, beautiful handball, Turbill to Ace, and what a goal, Norwood!
down towards Thomas. And now this is a great grand final. Not that it hasn't been a great grand final right from the start of the game, but it has been hard and tough. And this is Philip Gallagher. A short cropping kick over, and Norwood are working into an attacking position. Turbill from just out of the 25 metres out.
It's a magnificent movement, Ian Aiken. I think the crowd suddenly got a bit of there was a bit of a hush over the crowd because Port Adelaide looked as though they had it. But Norwood, with four clever short passes forward, put themselves in a position to get a goal.
Now, Turbill very rarely misses these goals. He's an excellent kick for goal. That's his second. Great pressure, great performance, and great skill. On for Dunstan. Dunstan down in towards the forward pocket. Eckerman's back there. And so is Turbill. And that's a tremendous effort by little Turbill. Here it comes again on the replay. Turbill coming in there. All the strength of his pain-ridden body.
Wilcock attempts a one-hander. Burgess thumps the ball out towards Hoffman. Aish has followed up well. Aish goes short towards Turbill. Turbill takes a fine mark. And the red legs will go forward from the outer wing as Gallagher with a long drop punt looking towards Turbill. And Turbill over the back has taken a spectacular mark.
Whatever he's done tonight has certainly had the stamp of class about it. As Turbill looks for the lead up forward, he gets it. It's Delwood out in front, well spoiled by Kennedy. Into trouble, out of trouble. Back towards the centre half forward position. Hamilton is there, been a prominent player. Turbill, touch of class and everything he's done tonight. Lines up towards goal, legs back within 5 points with that fine goal.
Tackle from Kennedy towards Jenkins. Jenkins with a handball. Turbill's played particularly well, works the ball.
Time gets under the left boot, high right down into the deep of goals. Over the top there was Sims, tapped away there towards Turbill. Turbill snaps under the right boot, and there's Norwood's first. Pleasant quickly looking for Colasanti. He got those big arms up there and taken the mark in the forward pocket. Plays on quickly, that's short and dangerous. Can Norwood get in there? Yes, they can, through the agency there of Greg Turbill. Turbill taking a sigh of relief there because there was plenty of stirred players on his hammer. And took a very, very courageous mark. It's about 10 metres from goal, straight in front, and should have no difficulty in posting his third goal. It's a very important and crucial goal for the Red Legs. There's the kick from Turbill. Oh, did it easily.
Yeah, so is Dunstan. And that man, Fosdijk, playing well. Handballs to Jenkins, to Turbill, and Norwood looking good.
Coleman's gone back to have a flying leap at it. Button just determined not he's going to do it. It's going to be awful close. He's made the distance. He's made a goal.
Bounced by Schofield. Hudson over the top to West Torrens. Menzel, first player to the ball. Has the running Michael Ace. Back towards centre half forward. Looking for Turbill. Turbill, great mark. Great mark. Dropped that mark as he should have taken. Colasanti. Rambo in late. There's a chance for Norwood. Turbill in towards goal. Kick coming around. Has it come out enough? I think he has. Turbill's
booted
a lovely goal.
Michael Ace at centre-half forward. The lead's from Delwood. Turbill's over there as well. And in right for Turbill. Good judgment. Great mark.
Time running out for the Red Legs. They trail by 8 points. 26 and a half minutes of the final term gone. Goes short. It's not a good kick. Benton Miller should have taken the mark. A free kick to the Norwood player. Met high. Greg Turbill, number 17, directly in front. Only 20 metres from goal. Has booted one goal, kick number 15. Can Norwood get back? 27 minutes of the final term. They trail by 8 points, and Greg Turbill directly in front from 20 metres. Makes no mistake in the game. He really comes
very, very hard. It's Fosdijk that got it to Menzel. Menzel's long handball to Colasanti for Barton. Barton has a running player in Jenkins. Jenkins at the centre of the ground. Goes short towards Turbill. And the little fella has accepted the mark at centre-half forward. Well, what a kick. What an important kick. He's gone short towards Teal.
David Darcy, how would you like to meet Jimmy Teal? He's 30 metres from goal, directly in front, almost 30 minutes of the quarter gone, and they trail by two points.
My eyes are riveted on Neil Baum, standing in the square, head down, and the thoughts that must be running through his mind at the moment. 30 minutes gone as Teal lines up from 30 metres out with just 2 points of difference.
Oh,
Matt Davern. Sweeps them out wide. Fosdyke, the chance. Sets up Greg Turbill. Plenty of room for through for the little goal. There's the answering goal. A good goal for him. Two goals to Greg Turbill.
Ace swoops. So does Filkey. No running support. Gives it back to Woodcock. The chip away at goal goes in high. Up high, Turbill! Oh, a great...
Been interchanged. And the Norwood camp has given him a big cheer as he comes back on. Jenkins sends him again at the back of the pack. A chance for Menzel. Turbill immediately in the action. Ace over the top of the ball, and the umpire will come in for a bounce. And oh, Turbill's immediately in it. We've got troubles. Umpire Foster there being swamped by players. She's on. Players coming from everywhere.
How can you be complacent at this stage with 25 minutes into the second quarter and a lot of Norwood players playing at half pace?
Menzel hung out to dry. Craig over the top. In goes Michael Ace. Spill back in defence. Ace butters up again. Slips it over to Turbill. Hooks for the big white stick. Great thing. He butters it. Oh, what a beautiful pass.
Gets around Vivian with consummate ease. Steadies. Boots short to Turbill. He's got clear. No, he's not. He's in trouble. But has Stepper going. Barton gets clear, gets a handball out to Gallagher. Gallagher over the top to Turbill. Turbill to Ace, brilliant football by Norwood, and a goal.
Comes to Andrew Ace, in towards full forward, Hartfield, Cochran back there. Ace to Turbill, magnificent. You saw it in your screen. Is that talent?
By Michael Ace, his favourite to win the McGarry medal. Have a look at this, going the wrong way, slips it back to Turbill, beautiful football, and little Turbill with his left foot has banged through his fourth goal.
The quiet player for the Dogs today. Towards centre wing. Turbill up high, had the sit and the mark. Deemed himself. Here it is in replay. Had the sit and did just that.
Wee's cleverly out of trouble to the left foot. The lead is on in the pocket from Turbill. Ah, beautiful diving mark, Greg Turbill.
Here it is in replay. The kick from Lachlan. A fine mark by Turbill. Diving. Ian Chapman would be proud about his height. On with the game we go. The long kick in towards full forward. Over the back there, Fosdyke. In front, it was Michael Annie. Turbill snaps. I think it's home. Right goal.
In the middle of adversity, Norwood have lifted. Michael Annie to Turbill. And Greg Turbill misses very, very few goals. Through it goes for his first.
However, out there for Jenkins. Gets around one. Now steadies. Puts it on its way. In towards the teeth of goal. Turbill up high. He covers. Sweeps it around the corner. Is it a goal? Almost out in his feet. He banged his third and Norwood are home for all. Ball sets up for him. He's in business. It does. He runs himself into the bucket. Screws it around the corner. Oh, good thinking by Thomas. And he's found Turbill. Just when West Adelaide had gained their momentum, Norwood got the ball away from centre. And now Turbill with kick number 17. Lines up. He's kicked two, three in fact. As he kicked four, the umpire's going close to the post. We'll wait on his decision. It's a goal.
Sorry, Peter Martin.
Well, he plays that one pretty well, David, and I tend to agree with the umpire's decision then. Michael Ace puts himself in such a position where if you grab him, he hasn't got the ball. You've got to play it to him.
Kick to the half forward line. Good mark. Turbill. 20 metres out in front. This will be his 15th kick. He's put in his typical courageous effort. Shouldn't miss from here. Has got one in the first quarter. Towards the golf course end. The umpire doesn't move. Turbill second.
Well found by Winter. A fair bit of looseness in that back line by Glenelg. Turbill, sleight of hand, does it well. Kicks towards Ace. Oh, he's come into it. Ace has come into it the last two.
Jim Teal tears out of the fence. Gets up Turbill. He's gone down in a heap.
And right. Typical Greg Turbill boy he is, gets up on his feet.
I don't know, I would have thought that Turbill deserved a free kick. It's on. Dear Belton's had a go there and...
Could make it three. Kick number nine goes long towards Turbill. Cantle out to Turbill. Fine mark.
Adler goes short quickly to Turbill. He kicked nine goals last week for the Redlegs against Torrens. Short again to Michael Ace. He's come back to lead. Galani downs, put it down towards Aish. Aish could have a snap. He looks to Turbill. He set him up a bit. Turbill's courage will be all right, though. And it's in a half forward. Turbill must kick a goal for North.
He's played exceptionally well in this quarter, and in particular, he hasn't had a lot of it, but he makes everyone count, and he's keeping them in the game.
Turbill has kicked a goal. Aish tagged, working hard with Pape. Aish has lifted, showing the McGarry medal form. Long handball toward the pocket. Downs working, Radbone working in front of him, they're letting it go. Turbill will go backwards to Tom Warhurst and he takes the mark.
Well done, Greg Turbill.
Cool head in a crisis. Till working hard, trumped off one tackle. He's got to go short here and he's got Hughes if he wants him and he's got it. Hughes is going to play on. Kicks towards centre half forward. Turbill's there. Great mark. Thomas will go to centre half forward with a long one. Turbill trying to get back on it. Will it sit up for Michael Ace? Great tackle on Downs, but he got rid of it. Motley, another strong tackle on Motley. Michael Ace did it magnificently to Turbill, who fell over, recovered. Snapshot by Turbill, he's going to go close. It's going to go through. Magnificent.
Grant Filkey comes after him. Has plenty of time to look, go wide. Greg Turbill, the boy he's after, finds him. And the plucky little rover takes a good mark. After Greg Turbill stood the ground, like all courageous players should. Body under the fall of the ball. Let's see what he does with this kick. The drop punt looks good off the boot. Don Bill says, yes, that's a goal.
The intern will go for Turbill on the half back line. Turbill playing at the second.
Fosdyke standing alongside Asua. Warhurst knocks the ball forward. Thomas. Turbill. Oh, it's gone close. I think he's got it. What a goal, Turbill. Two goals to the runner, the game player. Just down to Motlop. To full forward, Hall in front, couldn't mark the ball. Thomas, if he can pick it up, he's in business. Play on, says the umpire. Back to Turbill. He's got another one. Front, can't mark. Cunningham, left boots at the centre half forward, but intercepting beautifully as Turbill. He gets it over to
Jenkins
for Norwood. Turbill, good mark. Very noticeable early, Turbill. Finds Matthews.
In goes Fairclough. Brooksby for South Adelaide, back towards Keane. Lachlan coming across. Turbill into the action. He gets met heavily. Doesn't look happy at all at the moment. And Turbill still in strife midfield, bending over. And it's not often you see Greg Turbill having to take a breather. It must have been a heavy knock indeed.
Mark, he hasn't done much today. Takes off towards Turbill. That's where it goes.
Turbill holds his ground.
There's a semblance of a trip there, but are not sufficiently impressed to give him 15 metres. Turbill, a very good shot for goal, but the distance may be against him. Norwood would pay big money for a goal. Turbill's kick is superb. Through it goes. Two to Turbill. A much needed one for Norwood. Allen taps it over the head. Beautifully done, Teal. He's lifted late lead. Aish. Oh, great mark. Put the hand up, Turbill. Super performance. It looked as though it was going to carry to Ace, but Turbill, what a player he is for Norwood. Doesn't matter what the conditions are, good or bad, he's always in there fighting.
Into the pocket goes Fosdyke. He wants it. Michael Annie wants it quickly in two. 19 minutes in. Michael Annie, well, at least Ace centres it towards the half forward line. A fine mark. Turbill, 40 metres out. Just about all the players, 30 of the 36 players, in fact, 32 of the 36 players are now in the Norwood attacking division. Kick number 15 to Turbill. He's already got three. Kick underway. I think that's home for all money. Well done, Turbill.
Does look in some difficulties. Turbill, Greg Thomas. He can use Turbill again here. He probably will. That's the way it'll go. Turbill, not the fastest player, but it's set up for him. He's got Neville Roberts short. Good football.
Michael Aish.
Turbill on a lead.
Beautiful mark, Greg Turbill. When he goes for the ball, he commits himself to it. Magnificent fly with the little fellow. Kept his eye on it, even when he missed it on the first grab.
If Mike Smith could get a couple of balls now for West Adelaide, kick a couple of goals, it'll help them. Ferring and Dijon. McIntosh over the top. That's a beautiful handball to Turbill. He's got a couple in the set if he wants. Turbill's going to have a shot for goal. That is going to go through. That's the one Norwood wanted.
He'll go short. puts a teammate under tons of pressure, stands the ground. Greg Turnbull, that's his usual style, puts the body where the ball is. Takes the marker at half back as drizzly rain begins to fall down. That will make conditions difficult. And a boomer by Greg Turnbull.
Robertson clear. Very lucky to get away with it. Thomas, Turnbull. Shoot is Jarvis. Kinnear's under pressure. Oh, there's more Norwood players. Turbill from behind, marked over Paul Clinton.
Who's under pressure now from Roberts. Chance Turbill out wide, however, is Thomas. But Turbill, once again, has that brilliant ability to pick up free kicks. And that's number 7 or 8 for the afternoon. And Neil Baum just acknowledges that very fact. Kick number 21, Turbill. A great performer for the Lakes. What an acting captain. Kick underway, and that is going to be home, I believe. Fourth goal. Gee, I wouldn't like to be playing them next week, Peter, and that's the Bays. Of course, 7 will be there. Neagle gets the ball out to Turbill. Uses pace to get round for Plesha, and a fine pass. Adler, is he going to pay it? Yes, he's paid. Adler. Norwood into attack again to the half-forward line. Turbill is out there. Good mark. He's got it. Jenkins runs on, but Turbill going back to kick long. Thomas makes the break. So does Neagle. Around Cantalaftis. Goes in short to Neagle in the pocket. No, Thomas has got it. Thomas 30 metres out. Steadies, and he puts his second goal on the ball. Roberts back to Button. Goes right across looking for Neagle. Turbill there. He should kick a goal out of this. Hooks it back. The umpire. Thomas looking to pass off on the leaders. Michael Annie. Thomas up at the back of the pack. Roberts wants help. Gives a chance. Turbill, 40 metres out. Pops it onto the boot. It's closed. I think it's a goal. Aishin coming through. Andrew Aish had his brother there, Michael Ferring, looking for somebody. Turbill thought about the handball. Goes long himself. It's going to be touch and go. This could be a magnificent goal. Posdike to the half forward line looking for Jim Michael Annie. The big fellow's in there. Takes a good mark. Thomas will get the next one out wider. You'll find Turbill. Turbill over the half forward line. He's going to go for home with a long one. It's a nice looking kick. I think it's going to be a goal. They're two fine wins against Port and West. We're both at home. They're going to have to battle from here. Sturt's fight back has been brilliant. Turbill works hard all day. Comes across to Jenkins. That's a good pass. Here's a chance. Teal. He's got the sit of the ball. Drives to the half forward line. Trying to get there is Thomas. Almost gets it on the half volley. Recovers well. Well shepherded. Gets it over to Turbill. Here's a chance. Should be a goal. He'll give it to Michael Ace. No, into goal. He goes. And Lord has tied the game.
Hofner underneath it. He can't mark it. Neagle recovers best. Got an opportunity. Beautiful pace and movement by the young fellow. Crossed the centre of the ground to Roberts. That's a very good kick. It had to be accurate because if Rocky missed it, the rebound was on for Port Adelaide. Roberts going short to Turbill accurately. And Turbill now 55, 60 metres from goal, requiring his best kick, but a slight trailing breeze would give him the opportunity.
That play of Neagle's on the centre wing was fantastic. His recovery was marvellous then.
He's got some great burst of speed.
This will take Turbill's very best. Drop punt is a strong one. Turbill gets his first.
Ball knocked forward by Port Adelaide to Bradley. Ebert. Turbill recovers for Moore. Short to Michael Ace. Another bad bounce. Turbill blocking. Centre of the ground. Turbill. Gallagher's made a lot of yards. Turbill recovers. Gallagher has a look. Beautiful play. Gary McIntosh has been shifted from the centre. This time he doesn't miss.
Phillips from the back can't mark it. Thomas puts his hand on the ball and just knocks it out to Turbill. And they've got it. It's a magnificent bit of play on the ground there.
Caught. Lucky. Short. Turbill. Turbill will take off. Roberts is on a lead. Beautiful pass. Straight down his throat.
But he's going over that player's head. Screws one in towards Seabone. McGuinness first recover. Beautifully done. Turbill, however. He'll go short to Fosdike. And that's one department where the legs have outstripped, or more than one, I suppose, but one of them has been there kicking the position. He in turn finds Turbill. Roberts gives the lead. Likewise, Teal going in high, but it's Button. Frost. Roberts wants backup support. Turbill, dummies twist into the open goal. I think he's missed. Oh, he did everything right except kick a goal. Thomas. run the legs off his counterpart. Turbill's got to beat Liu. Does it well. Goes in short, Nagel.
Players running everywhere. He goes past Duthie, then short. Turbill at centre-half forward. Well, this marks the end to a great season by the Norwood Football Club, Ian.
Yes, Peter. Did you see the frustration on Graham Corns' face then? Whose man is this? I can't pick up the whole lot. But that epitomises Norwood all day. They're always finding the spaces, always running, and they've just made the base chase Guernseys all afternoon. It's been a superb performance.
Disposal by Norwood has been magnificent. 23 kicks coming up for Turbill. He's the captain. He got his first goal. He'd be pretty happy. 20 goal, 13 Norwood. Maynard goes to centre-half forward. Sewer's got the ball. But they're all playing from memory at the moment. Here it is. 32 minutes, 55 seconds into the last quarter. The siren's gone. Neil Barmer's getting the pats on the back and the accolades from all of his colleagues. A great victory, Norwood. 20 goal, 13, Tiggle-Nell, 9-17. Neil Barm congratulating his players. There's Neville Roberts. That's his first grand final. He didn't play in one with Richmond. There's Philip Gallagher. It was pretty hard for him to come back into the team. Wayne Smale is 42 there. Barm is a very popular character with the Norwood club, the Norwood people, and more particularly or more significantly with the Norwood players. Neil Button is number 30. It's been a great year for Norwood. They destroyed the opposition in the last 2 months. They had a record victory against Port Adelaide at the parade. They beat Sturt by 10 goals at Unley. Neville Roberts kicked 10 that day, kicked 11 the following week. Barmy is delighted.
Congratulations, Brett.
Thank you very much.
And there it is for you.
It's unbelievable, it's marvellous. Bad luck, Gunnelg. Did it the hard way, run out in the end. I'd like to thank all those magnificent men there. Coach Neil Barm, Wally Miller, and of course your spectators. It's beautiful.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you'd all like to hear from the coach, Neil Barm. Neil Barm.
Well, I've had enough things to say today. The only thing I'll say now is what a magnificent effort from these guys.
Has hugged a few things in his life, but he's never hugged anything as memorable as that. The Premiership Cup, what a great comment from Mr. Max Bashir, the SANFL president, when he said, go for a run around the Oval, lads. You wouldn't think they'd have the energy, but magnificent victory.
Well done. Norwood skipper.
She's not getting drowned, here.
Greg Turbill, me too, mate. So that's to send the dry cleaning building as well, mate.
I think I'll worry about it now. It's beautiful, isn't it?
It is a great feeling.
Yeah.
And to be the skipper of the side, of course.
Just acting captain or whatever. It's just nice to be out there. It's playing amongst a great side as we are, and we really play as a team and we feel for each other, and that's what's got us through today.
Turbs, halfway through the season, Norwood weren't going well.
I don't know,
there was a chance, there was even thoughts at one stage you wouldn't make the five.
Yeah, we are known as late starters, Dave, and we knew what our job was, and we had the same team, but the positions were different, and we weren't having runners And as soon as we introduced runners into the game, you know, young Neggs, young Thomas, McIntosh, Keith Thomas, you know, they've all been exceptional for us, and it's just been very good.
I can remember talking to John Wynn about that time, and he said, well, there's a number of youngsters that we want to try. Those became great players in Nagel, Jarvis,
yeah,
McIntosh, all those players have experienced and have been matured so quickly.
Well, yeah, that goes for so much respect for the coach, you know, and he's tutored them along, and they've had magnificent foundation as far as skill goes through Winnie and staff and Smithy and underage bunch of coaches, and it's been excellent. You know, I really feel for the guys that were injured during the year in the last couple of games, you know, Noves, Nico, Jarvo, they're all been magnificent help to us.
Just quickly, how does this compare with 78?
Oh, this is the thrill of my life.
Is it?
Yeah,
well
just,
done, mate.
Just one.
Congratulations.
Andrew Ace, the crumbs. He wants someone to kick it to, but he hasn't got anyone. Adler picks it up, kicks it forward. Oh, good mark by Turbill. A very good mark in front of Whittles.
Got a goal as we approach the time on mark. Onto the lead, Roberts. Good mark. Gee, had to fling himself at the ball. He's about 45 metres out on the lead. Turbill. Good pass. Turbill is 20 metres out. Norwood badly need a goal. I think the skipper's put it through. They go. Fosdyke. Norwood going down the ground in waves. Turbill again. Good mark. Quickly now Thomas. Needs support. Well shepherded McIntosh. Oh, here's all Norwood. McIntosh directs play to Turbill into the open goal.
Neil Button and Peter Carey. Carey blocking, interfering, straight, then whacks McIntosh in the stomach. He takes no notice, gets it across to Turbill. It's too far. Yeah, left behind as Turbill just took it out off his chest. All Turbill's got to do is kick it straight. He can't do that. He's kicking to Roberts.
Kernahan takes off early. Button to arm that. High kick. Turbill getting underneath it. Oh, that's a courageous mark. Running the wrong way. Had Roberts and Stringer coming at him. And the Norwood captain kept his eye on the ball, and he took a very, very good mark. Deep in the pocket. Look at Roberts. Robert, have a look at him. He's just walking back very, very slowly. He might turn around in a minute. Keith Thomas.
No, he Thomas didn't. Led.
Yes, now he goes, Roberts, but he's not going to look for him. Kick by Turbill. Looks pretty good. He's got it. That's a goal to Turbill. That's a very good goal from the pocket. His first. Button and Carey. Button just took it off Carey. Carey tapped it straight to him. Keith Thomas and McFarlane. Keith Thomas to Turbill. Now here's a goal. Drop punt. 11 to Norwood in this term. And Turbill's got two, and it is all so easy.
It's not easy really, Bruce. What it is, it's accurate. Turbill hobbling back the centre a bit, but he's certainly a plucky little player. He's not going to give up. That leg's giving him one devil of amount of trouble. You can see him there limping on that hip.
And what a McGuinness, but he ran into trouble and had nobody to give it to. Marshall looking to dodge rather than looking to give. Button, Holst, and also Turbill.
Terrific.
He's got skills, hasn't he, to Gallagher in the centre.
Getting back quickly for Norwood. Michael Aish to centre half forward. Turbill coming from behind. He's going to fly. What he used to do when he was a youngster, and that's how he likes him.
Gallagher in front, and Button flying over the top. Turbill's down in the pocket with Roberts. Oh, it's a beautiful kick, Neil Button's got real strength in it. That is a magnificent kick. That ball must have travelled 55 metres, and I don't think it went any higher than about 6-8 feet off the ground, I would say, all the way there. That's Greg, 3 metres.
Greg Turbill obviously feeling the effects of that hip injury from last Monday. Caught a number of times today. He's virtually playing as a permanent forward pocket. Hit the post about 2 minutes ago. Norwood want their captain to go. It's a good kick. He's got it. That's a captain's goal by Turbill. A steadier for Norwood. They're back in business a little. It's 11-5 to 13-10.
Marl receiving from Michael Aish. He's slipped over. Taps the ball out. Good umpire. The game allowed to let run. As Aish runs over half forward and Turbill in the pocket. Candelastis once again running up the ground loosely. Turbill waves, he's going to have a shot for the goal. Gallagher's on his own. just standing out in the middle of the ground, Gallagher. Turbill's not interested. He scored a full point.
Neagle's kick. Well, it's off the side of his boot, but there's Turbill's marked it, the skipper. And they're doing a great job, Norwood. And of course, I bet all the people back there in South Australia are really sitting on the edge of their seats, Barak, with the time, because this is the first time we've seen a South Australian side put up such a good save.
Knight coming on for Footscray.
Knight coming on the ground, and Williams off the ground. Turbill going for a shot here, directly in front, and that's a goal.
Roberts playing in front and doing it well. Up towards full forward, looking for the skipper. Turbill, he's got the mark, and a good one it was, too.
That was a gutsy mark, too.
No stage did he take his eyes off the ball. He didn't worry at all who was coming behind him. He just kept the eye firmly on it, and that's why he...
He's run all day, Schmal. Gets around corns. Lines the goal up. The kick is not a good one. Oh, Turbill read it well. He came in very late, Turbill. And he's marked the ball at centre-half forward. And the number of times the Norwood Rover would miss from here would lead one to speculate that this is a lay-down mazere. Kick number six to the Norwood captain. Dragged it just slightly, but he got the result he wanted. Turbill has kicked his first goal. Norwood a 10-7, South 7-4.
He took the mark and then stood there. Didn't try and run back to get onto the lead quickly.
O'Dwyer provides a lead. Turbill's got the mark. That one floated over the back.
Turbill must have thought it was Christmas all at once.
See, that was a great reflex take there, Bruce. He took that on the ground almost.
Slips catch.
Oh, beautiful kick. Beautiful take. Panicky, they can't get it to each other at all. Neagle goes to full forward. Clisby, ball straight through his hands. Turbill says, thank you very much. He kicks his first goal for the quarter.
He's worked hard, Bruce, the big fellow. He's made opportunities for the team.
McIntosh to Neagle, to Teal, to Gallagher. Gallagher to Turbill. Turbill should go. And does. And Norwood are 4-4. And South Adelaide are 5-6.
To Harvey.
Danny Hughes was a bit reluctant to run on for him. Danny looked at him and Hughes was just stood there and looked back, put Harvey under a lot of difficulty.
Andrew Ace to the goal square, Turbill. Robertson and Roberts were jostling. Turbill stood there and accepted the mark.
Norwood attacking from defence. The kick's a bit wide. Turbill has been hit. I think he'll be all right. John Harvey ran into him. It was almost bang. Turbill went to play on.
Leading sports news tonight, Greg Turbill has finally run out of legs. The most notable knee at Norwood has forced the Redlegs' last Premiership skipper to make the most difficult decision a footballer faces, when to call it quick.
Well, it was one of the hardest decisions I've ever had to make, and as you said, after 10 years and 13 years at the club, all my football career was almost there, and I find it very hard to make a decision like that, but you've got to come to the end sometime, and I believe that with the youth and that we've got at the club at the moment, and the club thought it was best that I'll retire.
Have three premierships helped to soften the blow somewhat?
They certainly do help soften the pain of the things, but each premiership's got something different about it, and I've enjoyed playing with them and the teammates about it, and I don't think you can, like more premierships, but every time you win one, it's very gratifying.
You'll be missed by spectators and scribes, but I'd imagine there'd be one or two opponents around who won't be heartbroken to see you quit the game. Of all the people you've played against, anyone there stand out?
Well, I know it's hard. It's very hard to try to pick out an individual you play against because you're out there to do a job on a given day. Probably the hardest person I've ever come across, and that was when I was, I thought at my youngest, was when I, in my first 2 years, it was John Murphy for Sturt here. He taught me a big lesson one day.
He unsettled you, but did he?
Well, I thought I had him beat, but he tapped me on the shoulder. I've never done it again.